Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about the truth about living out here in Mexico. All right, I'm kind of just doing this for a minute, see if I can get a thumbnail. All right, you see, that's kind of like what I do, but sometimes I take a little longer. All right, so I'm just going to place this here for a minute. Go for a little bit of a walk and talk. All right. Well, as you guys know, I haven't been doing a lot of these walks and talks for a while because I've had a bum foot. I haven't been able to walk much and a little bit of pain still. But hey, it's all good though. It's fine. You know, I get to still walk in my backyard for a little bit. So yeah, this is my backyard. All right. I'm sure you guys already know. You guys have been here with me before. So, and now we're just going to head back here, you know, since there's a little shade back there, and we're just going to be talking a little bit, all right? Just decided to take you with me since I know you guys love the walks and talks, but, you know, this is as far as I can really walk and talk right now. So, just telling you like it is. You know, tomorrow I'm actually going to the store. As you're watching this episode, I'm going to be at the store getting new shoes and fixing myself and getting all better and all that good stuff. So, yeah. Oh, all right. So, today we're going to be talking about, you know, the truth about living out here in Mexico. And again, it's not just living out here in Mexico, but we're going to, you know, elaborate a little more. And, you know, what the real truth about, you know, what it is to live abroad really means. That's what today's episode is going to be about. We're just going to be talking about that. Just shooting the shit a little bit about that. Now, little caveat. Before I moved out here to Mexico, it wasn't really my intention to come out here and live out here in Mexico. For years, you know, I was already in my mind thinking, oh, I want to leave. I want to live abroad. I want to, you know, do all that stuff. But what I always ended up doing was just moving to a different part of the country. And I lived all over the U.S. But it wasn't until I had like a pretty much an economic financial situation, you know, hit me like a ton of bricks. In fact, I'm going to use a quote from Mike Tyson that says, everybody has a plan until you get punched in the face. And that's pretty much what happened. You know, we all, you know, I had, you know, my plan, you know, everything was going great. And then, bam, punch in the face. And then, you know, all of a sudden that plan goes out the window. So I had to pretty much overnight figure out what the fuck I was going to do. And within like a 2-week time span, I ended up moving out here to Mexico. Sorry, just seeing, I'm guessing that's there's something flying around here. Okay, it looked like a bee. All right, we're safe. Not a hornet or anything like that. But anyways, and I moved out here. So even though I'm out here and living out here and doing this whole fucking thing, it took me a long ass fucking time to make the decision, you know, not just to make the decision, but to actually, you know, come out here and do this. Still keeping an eye on that bee. Sorry, I'm a little distracted. I don't even know what the fuck it is. I'm guessing it's a bee. There's more than one of them. You know what? I feel like there's a lot of them around here. I'm going to relocate for a minute, okay? Last thing I want is to get stung by whatever the fuck that was. And by the way, I'm out here barefoot. So, yeah, this is my backyard, too. Look, it's like all this green forest moss. I don't know what the fuck that is. But see, look, I'm barefoot. So, it's no bueno. But anyways, okay. So, let's just get to the story. Story time, right? That's what we're talking about here. So, you know, pretty much, you know, a lot of you guys probably think that, you know, I just came out here. You know what I mean? Like, you know, I planned this for a long time. I wanted to do this. I did it the right way. I came out here and blah, blah, blah. No, I mean, not really. You know, really what kind of happened was, again, you know, long story short, I was, you know, thrown out for, you know, lack of a better explanation of where I was living. I wasn't thrown out. It was just I was living with roommates. They all had, you know, they all were living in L.A. like me. They couldn't realize their, you know, L.A. dream, Hollywood dream. So they all went back to Alabama, Mississippi, Florida, wherever the fuck they were from. And I had no place to live. And I couldn't find a place to live in L.A. It was too expensive. But, hey, I was able to find a place out here extremely cheap. So that's why I came out here. And then once I finally did come out here, I was like, holy shit, this is awesome. I fell in love with living out here, and that's it. That's where I am. Now, the reason I'm really making today's video is because in the last, like, day or two, last couple days, I've been getting a lot of, you know, this has been a topic of conversation with a lot of people in my circle. So, you know, I was talking to my cousin the other day. She's around my age, a little older, and we were talking, and, you know, as we were ending the conversation, she asked me, as she always asks me, so when are you going to come visit, you know, America again? When are you gonna come visit the US again? And I'm like, probably not anytime soon. There's no reason for me to go back. I mean, the only reason I have to go back to the US is to visit you guys. And you guys are coming to visit me out here, so what the fuck do I, you know, what do I gotta go visit for? Sure, I miss hamburgers and In-N-Out. I miss certain things about culture and life and living in the US, because I am American at the end of the day. Even though I'm Cuban, born in Miami, and it's a little different where I'm from, you already know, Florida, Miami. Anyways, oh, look at that. Finally, sorry, I got a little distracted. Limes, look at my lime tree. It has limes, finally. All right, geez, these limes are amazing. Anyways, so, you know, I was just telling her, look, I don't really plan on moving. I mean, I kind of plan on staying here for a long time, but when I do move, when I travel again, it's not going to be going back to the States. I've already seen the States. I've already been all over the States. I have nothing new to see in Miami. I got nothing new really to see anywhere else. But I really do have the whole world in front of me that I want to see. All of it. I mean, literally, I've only been to 3 countries. Canada, the US, and Mexico. So that literally leaves the rest of the world wide open for me to go visit. And just like you guys watch me and watch other YouTubers that travel and have these little travel vlogs, videos, whatever, well, guess what? I mean, I love watching those too. I mean, I used to be a chef. yeah, sorry about that. I try to keep it as real as possible. Even, again, the good, the bad, the ugly. I was almost about to do something nasty there. But anyways, look, the point is that, like, I used to love Bourdain. I still love him, but, you know, we already know he doesn't do his show anymore for obvious reasons. Poor guy. But the point is that's like, yeah, I mean, I used to love Bourdain even before he had his own show. I read his book. I knew about him even before that. Again, being a chef, old school chef. So, you know, the whole thing of travel vlogging and or travel shows and all that, that's always been part of, like, something I've always wanted to do my whole life. And now, as I stand here in front of this GoPro and I'm talking to you guys, even though I'm not really doing much except, look at the plane. I don't know if you guys can see it, probably not. But as I'm talking to you guys out here and doing the videos that I do and doing the things that I do, I'm literally realizing that dream that I've always wanted to have, you know, of being a vlogger, a travel vlogger, a traveler. Again, why I became a chef is because my intent was that, you know, I was going to be traveling the world and doing all that awesome stuff, which never kind of came to fruition. Another story for another day. But the point is that now I'm actually getting to realize these, you know, these dreams, you know, and realize, you know, what I've always wanted to do. And it all kind of came about in, you know, the weirdest way possible. I mean, it wasn't something that just, you know, I was planning for. It was just something I always wanted to do and just kept working and working and working at it. And now here I am and I'm doing this and I want to do more. But anyways, the reason you guys really clicked on this video is because you guys want to know the truth about living in Mexico. Look, I'm going to sum it up real quick. The truth about living in Mexico is that it's like living anywhere else, only it's better. I mean, I've said it many, many times before. And what do I mean by better? Well, it all depends on what you're looking for and what you're looking for out of life. If you're perfectly happy living in the US, then, you know, moving to Mexico isn't really a fucking thing for you. But if you're extremely unhappy living in the US, which I think a lot of people are right now, then living in Mexico is not only a viable option, but it's fucking incredible option. And the fact that it's so close and right next to you. But what I'm not here to talk about Mexico in depth so much. It's really more about, you know, just the truth about living abroad. The reason I just named the episode was, you know, the truth about living in Mexico is because, you know, I play with the little algorithms a little bit and all that good stuff, and I just want to make sure that I get the most hits possible. A little trick of the trade there. But anyways, look, the point is that it's like the truth about living abroad. And what is the truth about living abroad? Well, it's like this. You don't know what it's like until you actually do it. And then once you actually do it, you get addicted to it. Most people do. And that's kind of like where I'm at now, you know, where I'm living abroad and I don't plan on ever going back to that slavery of a 9-to-5. I mean, I feel bad and horrible for everyone that has to live that life. But at the same time, it's like that is your choice. I mean, I've never lived that life. No matter. I mean, I've worked a billion hours a day, you know, for fucking years, you know, being a chef. As anyone knows anything about that industry, you know, I'm working 12 hours a day, 6 days a week, 7 days a week. No break. So, I mean, even though I've worked like an animal, I've still never even worked that 9-to-5 type of thing. I don't even know what the fuck that is. And for all of you guys out there listening to me right now that are probably in your 9-to-5 or God knows what the hell you're doing out there, you guys are always just, you know, asking me all kinds of questions. It's like, you know, why do I live out here? Why is this so much better? Or just, you know, basically, again, back to like why I started making this episode. It was my cousin telling me, why don't I go back? I already told you why. And I told her why, even though I say it over and over again to her and others. But then, you know, the other question I get, which I got from somebody actually a little while ago this morning, was someone was asking me, I want to move out here to Merida, or I want to move out to, you know, another country. But specifically, they said they want to move out here. And then the basic question that they asked me is like, what do I need to do? How do I get rid of all my stuff? And how do I move out there? I mean, you know, that question couldn't have been more broad. But at the same time, you know how many times I've get that question all the fucking time? A lot. And the thing is, how I answered that was that, well, I can't really tell you how to do that. All you got to do is do it. I mean, there's not really much to think about here. I mean, the thing is, again, for me, I'm just like a little bit of a different situation. I am living almost the life of someone that had a very, very successful life, career, job, all this stuff, and then they got divorced and lost it all. The thing is, I never got divorced. I never had that situation. Therefore, you know, I'm in a little bit of a better situation because I don't have to pay like alimony or child support or any of that shit, you know? But I also, you know, kind of, you know, dealt with a similar situation where all of a sudden I had a lot of awesomeness, you know, like a lot of financial stability, and kind of like overnight, like that, lost it all to no fault of my own. And, you know, I had to start over from the very, 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 very beginning. And again, literally lost it all. So even as I was living in LA, I had already lost it all. Like, I mean, literally, all of my shit got stolen. Every single thing. I mean, a lot of you guys are always complimenting me on my shirts. You know how many more awesome fucking shirts I had before I lost it all? You know, do you even know what the feeling is of someone stealing every single fucking thing that you own? Everything, like literally everything. I mean, you know, as dumb as a t-shirt and socks and clothes, to like your yearbook, to, you know, hard drives, you know, full of memories, to all kinds of things. And so, you know, that happened to me. I literally lost every single fucking thing. I lost all my money. I lost everything, you know, having to be, you know, being put through the judicial ringer. Which at the end of the day, I didn't do anything wrong, but you already know how it works in the US. You get arrested and you get trialed and you get all that shit, and then you gotta prove your innocence. And then once you do prove your innocence, you don't get anything back except, sorry. So, you know, that was kind of like my situation. So by the time that I moved out here, I was already living a minimalistic life. Even though I've always been pretty minimalistic, at this point in my life, it wasn't really by choice. It was really more kind of forced on me. So, you know, when I had to make the decision of moving out here and packing my bags and, you know, getting rid of whatever the fuck I had, you know, that was I couldn't take with me, it really wasn't that hard of a decision, or it wasn't that hard of a thing or a move or anything like that, because I didn't have much. But the thing is that for you guys, it's extremely, extremely difficult, because if it's very difficult for you guys to move from just one house to another house, you know, within the same city, let alone from state to state, I mean, I can't even imagine moving from country to country. And so, you know, part of living abroad okay, part of like living out here, and then, you know, not just that, but then taking it to the next level where you want to, like, let's say, do what like I am or others, which is I want to live in a different country every few years. I want to travel a lot more. Even if I want to have a home here in Mexico, you know, you got to be very, very minimalistic for the most part. You know, once you get to a certain financial situation, you know, and it's a little different, but for the most part, you know, you got to be extremely minimalistic in order to make all this shit happen. And that, I think, is like the major problem for most people. Most people that can do this like I am is only because they're already living the minimalistic life. So for them, you know, they're probably living out of their car. They're probably living in a fucking little studio. They're probably living, again, like with nothing. So for them, the idea, just like for me, to, you know, pack your two bags with like your four pieces of clothes and the three things that you own isn't really that difficult. And then leaving to like another country is actually pretty fucking easy and very desirable looking at the options you have within your situation at the moment in the States. But when it comes to other individuals out there, a lot of individuals out there that are working their 9 to 5, they have, you know, a house, or they got a family, or they got, you know, this career, they got all this, and then they got a house, or not a house, but an apartment, or whatever the fuck you got, but you got it full of stuff, then all of a sudden this idea is more like a dream and not something that you can really realize, because just the idea of getting rid of everything and starting brand new is such a daunting, insane, crazy task that you just give up before you even start. And that's the thing. So in order for you to really be able to, you know, the truth about living in Mexico, the truth about living abroad, the truth about all this shit is the fact that you got to be mentally fucking prepared and ready. And that takes a lot of fucking work, because it's like anything else. Let's say I want to lose weight. It's not about it's eating healthy and doing exercise and all the shit that they always tell you about. But the main fucking thing is also you got to have your mindset ready. You got to change your mindset. You got to be, you know, willing to take it to the next level. You got to be, you know, wanting the desire to fucking really do this. And once you do, then everything just... It just happens. It just comes. It's not really a big fucking deal. It's really not that difficult. Everything just happens to, you know, happen. Look, this is like a beautiful butterfly. Look at this. And, you know, again, you know, moving out here, you know, all of a sudden, you know, just going, you know, once you change your mindset, once you do that, once you do everything you got to do, then all of a sudden things become easier. But, you know, in the end, there was nothing in the universe that I would have been able to really prepare me to move out here. I mean, to live out here, to want to be out here, unless I had such a horrible, you know, again, I was in such a horrible, dire situation back in LA before I moved out here, where I had two choices. It was either A, you know, move, you know, live on the streets, you know, like a lot of people are doing right now, or B, just gather all my shit and get the fuck out of Dodge and move out here. And again, you know, most people are, you know, even though they have that same exact option, most people are still too scared to leave, and they stay, and it sucks. And again, look, you know, even though the reason I chose here is because yo hablo español, yo soy cubano, you know, yo tengo dos idiomas, you know, me, what I just said is like, I'm Cuban, I speak Spanish, you know, to me moving out here wasn't really that big of a fucking deal, but to a lot of you guys don't even speak Spanish, so moving out here is a fucking daunting task. But that's why I'm always, you know, even though I live out here, I always talk about just living abroad in a more broad perspective, you know, in a more general terms, because there's a lot of places out there in the world where, you know, sure, it's India or Thailand or Philippines or whatever, and they speak their own language, but a lot of people out there speak English, and it would just be a lot easier for you to move out there. So for example, you know, I'm with my girlfriend now, you know, we're both artists, you know, she's into the same fucking boat and subscribing to the same thing as me, is like, okay, we're gonna be traveling and doing a bunch of cool shit. So now, you know, my thing to her is like, I'm trying to, you know, even though she knows English, it's like, okay, now we got to hone your English skills even further, because once we start traveling, they're most likely not going to be speaking Spanish. They're going to be speaking English. Most likely they're going to be speaking fucking whatever fucking language you don't understand. But at least with a strong base of English and Spanish, moving to other countries and, you know, using the technology we have in front of us and, you know, just taking, you know, just wanting to do this, it would be a lot easier to understand the language, understand what's going on, speak, you know, have, you know, all these options. But again, it all goes back to wanting to do this. You know, literally making a life decision out there, you know, for again, I've made many, many crazy life decisions, you know, but, you know, when I decided to move out here, it was literally on a whim, but it wasn't on a whim. You know, it was more like, okay, this is the next move. This is part of the adventure. This is where I'm going next. And as I've been out here, I'm telling you, I say it all the time. It was probably the best decision. I mean, because I've made a lot of really awesome decisions that have changed my life for the better in the last like 10 years. But honestly, this is probably one of the best, if not the best decision I've ever made in my whole entire life, period. End of story, was moving out here to Merida, Mexico. And it's not just because Mexico is fucking crazy awesome. It is. Merida is fucking crazy awesome. But it was just the whole idea, the whole experience, just doing this. Which now all of a sudden has opened up my mind, opened up so many more doors, opened up so much more, you know, for me. So I just keep getting bit by things. That's why I'm, you know, but just opened up the whole panorama for me to really, you know, now take this to the world, you know, now take this to the next level. I mean, I want to be a world traveler. That's one of the things I want to do. I want to do a lot of fucking things. And by doing those things, it's going to also allow me to be a world traveler, but it's all together. And that's the thing. And then as I'm doing these videos, it's like I want to continue to keep documenting everything, you know, as I travel, as I do everything. I want to just keep doing all the things that I'm doing and then keep taking it to the next level and to the next level. That's just my own personal thing. For you guys out there, I don't know what your own personal thing is. You know, for all you guys, you know, it just might be a little freedom, or it might be liberty. It might be financial stability. It might be, you know, a million things. But the point is that the real truth about living out here and living anywhere outside of your comfort zone is exactly that. Leaving your comfort zone and just fucking doing it already. And stop making excuses, because that's really all that's happening right now. It's just you're making excuses and that's it. And again, just like before I left LA, I could have had a million excuses as to why I didn't want to come out here. But that's not how I work. I'm a little bit, you know, backwards. In fact, before I came out here, what I really wanted to do was move to Venezuela, but that's a different story. Thank God I wasn't able to, because being an American and my visa situation, they just didn't allow me to do it. You know, Venezuela didn't want me in there, and it was too many hoops for me to jump through. And so that's why I opted to, fuck it, I'll move to fucking Mexico. And, you know, thank God I did, you know, in the long term, you know, after, you know, we already know what's happening over there and what's happening in other places. But the point is, I'm going to, you know, bring this all full circle, because that's it. It's already been talking here for a while. But at the end of the day, guys, just like the Nike Corporation likes to say, just do it. Okay. Stop making excuses. Stop, you know, you know, if Mexico isn't the right place for you, then keep looking. You know, there's like a fucking 200, 300 countries are all around the world that you can choose from and pick from. And again, you know, there's countries all over Eastern Europe, you know, where are nice and cold and snowing. And, you know, you're living cheaper than you're living here. There's parts of, you know, Asia. If you don't like, you know, Spanish, you can go to Asia, you know, and so on and so forth. You know, the world is yours. Like Scarface says, the world is fucking yours. So stop making excuses, all right? Start figuring it out and just do it. And that's really the truth. That's literally all I can really say about this whole thing. I know that this episode might not have been exactly what the title said, but I really do think it is. At the end of the day, the real truth about living out here is just the fact that you gotta just fucking do it. And if you come out here and you don't like it, well, it's just like if you move to another neighborhood and you don't like it, what do? You move again. And sure, it sucks, but you gotta do it. But at least you got the experience and the knowledge and all this other stuff that comes with, you know, doing the action that you're only gonna be able to do, you're only gonna be able to experience and get by actually doing the action. So just do it already, okay? Stop making excuses. All right, guys, I just want to give a shout out to all my patrons out there. I want to give a shout out to all my supporters. I want to give a shout out to everyone out there that is constantly, you know, sending me love, sending me donations, sending me sponsorships, everything. I want to give a shout out to everyone that signed up to my website, the new website, joseartega.com. Check it out. Links at the bottom. Shout out to everybody out there that's just constantly part of this whole community. I fucking love you guys. You guys are the best. And I think that's it, you know. So before I forget, don't forget to please like, please subscribe, please share, please hit that bell icon. And you know, more importantly than anything else, please stay awesome. And yeah, let's just not forget how awesome life really is, and that, you know, sure, you're watching this video, but should you be doing something else in order to start realizing your dream instead of watching my video? Exactly. Only you can answer that. So get to it. Get to work. All right. All right, guys. Love you guys. Peace out. And I'll see you guys mañana. Peace.